Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. I make videos on bags and fashion. In today's video, I'll show you my luxury handbag collection and I'll also include some mod shots and talk about the pros and cons of the bags. I don't have a huge handbag collection, but I'm very happy and grateful for what I have. I only keep bags that I love, and I don't like keeping stuff that I don't use, so I actually sold some bags that I no longer reach for. This is my handbag collection for 2020, and you see a lot of mini bags in this video because I love mini bags a lot. This video will focus on designer brands, and I do have some other bags from contemporary brands or high street brands, so I might do a separate video on those bags. If you have watched my other videos, you would know that Saint Laurent is one of my favorite brands and I have around 4 to 5 bags from them. I'll make another video to talk about my Saint Laurent collection in detail, so I won't be showing my Saint Laurent bags in this video. I'll make a video on my Saint Laurent collection soon, so make sure you're subscribed and stay tuned. So first of all, I want to show you my Toy Lulu bag in black with silver hardware. This is my dream bag, the love of my life, and it's currently my favorite bag undoubtedly. I got it last week and I've been using it non-stop. I've made a detailed review on this bag, so make sure you check out that video if you want to know how I style this bag and what fits in the bag. I honestly can't think of any cons of this bag. It's just a perfect mini bag for me. And the style is super classic, the leather is beautiful, and it fits a decent amount. I really love the thin leather strap, it's removable and adjustable. You can also use a silver chain to dress up the look, but I prefer using this leather strap because it's really comfortable and it's really chic and casual. The Toy Lulu bag features a snap closure, so it's really easy to open and close the bag, and it's also very secure. When you open the bag, you can see two main compartments with a central flat pocket. The bag also has some card slots in the interior, so sometimes I don't even need to use a card holder. As you can see, this bag can fit my daily essentials, including my iPhone 8 Plus, some makeup items, as well as my AirPods and a Saint Laurent card case. And if you're planning to use it as a travel bag, it can also fit your sunglasses. I think YSL bags are amazing and I really love the classic style. I might purchase another YSL bag in the future. So this is the newest bag that I added to my handbag collection and I'm very happy I finally got this dream bag. I love it a lot, it's really practical and it's also very fashionable. And the second bag I'm gonna show you is the Gucci Ophidia small bucket bag. I'll put the name and dimensions on the screen. I've made a video on my Gucci bucket bag and also my Fendi bucket bag, so check out that comparison video if you'd like to know more about the pros and cons of these two bucket bags. What I love about this bag is the canvas. It's really durable and vintage looking. It also has leather trimming and green and red stripes, so it's very classic and vintage. It has a drawstring closure like a lot of other bucket bags. It's actually pretty secure, so my things will not fall out. And I also like how this bag has a top handle. I always love a top handle bag. It also has a detachable and adjustable shoulder strap, so I can wear it as a top handle bag, as a crossbody bag, or a shoulder bag. It goes really well with my casual outfits and it's actually pretty practical because it fits a lot. I think it can even fit a book or like an iPad. As you can see, it can fit my iPhone 8 Plus no problem, a card holder, and of course my makeup items and also a book. I use this bag a lot and I don't really baby this bag, so I'm happy it does not stain or scratch easily and I can wear dark wash denim and there won't be any color transfer. So when it comes to cons, even though it's a really practical bag, I feel like it's a bit big for me. I'm about 5'2", I kind of wish I got the mini size instead. It looks cuter, but then again, the mini one does not have a top handle and it can't fit as much. So I really don't know which one is better. Comment down below and let me know what you think about this bag and whether it looks too big as a bucket bag. Talking about mini bucket bags, I do have a mini one. It's the Fendi Montrezza in this beautiful grey color. I believe this bag comes in different sizes and variations. There are different colors, and also the one with the Fendi monogram is super popular, and I saw a lot of YouTubers have that monogram bucket bag. I actually got this bag pre-loved from a Japanese consignment store, and I'm really happy with this purchase because it's in a great condition and it's such a great deal. This bag has drawstring closure and it's actually pretty easy to get in and out of the bag, and also it has beautiful gold metal hardware. This bag has a top handle and also an adjustable and removable shoulder strap. The long shoulder strap is pretty comfortable, and I like how it's a thin leather strap, so it looks great as a crossbody bag. Even though it's adjustable, it's still a bit long on me because I'm about 5'2". Because the strap is pretty long on me, I normally wear it as a crossbody bag and it hangs around my hips. When comparing to the Gucci Ophidia bucket bag, the Fendi Montrezza is smaller in size, and in my opinion, it's a bit cuter because I love mini bags a lot. And for a mini size bag, I think it can fit a decent amount, but of course it can't really fit my umbrella or my water bottle. So I use this Fendi bucket bag when I'm just going to grab lunch or running errands, and I would use the Gucci bucket bag when I have to fit a bit more and use it as a day bag. This is definitely one of my favorites because it's really versatile and the color of this bag goes well with a lot of outfits. The next bag I'm gonna show you is also a pre-loved bag that I got from a Japanese consignment store. It's the Louis Vuitton St. Cloud bag, and I featured this bag in my vintage bag collection video, so check out that video if you'd like to know more about my vintage bag collection. I really like the shape of this bag. I don't own any bag that looks like this, and it goes really well with casual outfits, especially t-shirts and jeans. And also the tassel is really cute on this bag. It has an adjustable leather strap, but the strap is not removable. This is my favorite vintage bag. I really like the style. It's super classic, and even though it's a vintage bag, I don't think it will go out of style. It has a magnetic snap closure, and when you open this bag, you can see a big main compartment, and it also has a slip pocket. It can fit all of my daily essentials, and I feel like this would be a great travel bag because it can fit my sunglasses and also a really small umbrella. The monogram canvas is pretty durable, and I don't have to worry too much when I'm using this bag. I like wearing it as a crossbody bag because then you can see the tassel, and it's a really cute and practical bag. The next bag I'm gonna show you is a Miu Miu bag, and it's actually a pretty old bag. I got it 4 years ago, so I don't really remember the exact name of this style, and I'm not sure if they still sell this at their store. I hope they still have bags that are similar to this style because it's really classic and elegant. I normally go for understated bags, and as you can see, this bag is not exactly understated because it has crystals and it's pretty sophisticated. But when I saw this bag, it was kind of like love at first sight. I thought it's really beautiful and I just had to buy it. When you look at the crystals, they are really shiny and they're not tacky at all, and I think they look even better in real life. The leather is also very great quality. It's really soft and supple. I really love the dainty chain of this bag. Even though it's not adjustable, it is removable, and I think the dainty chain adds a bit more elegance to this bag and elevates the look. When comparing to my other bags, this bag is really small and it does not fit as much, but it can fit my iPhone 8 Plus, my card holder, and my sunglasses, so I can use this as a travel bag. The leather of this bag kind of reminds me of my YSL Toy Lulu bag because the leather is also very supple and kind of gives a puffy look to this bag. But because the leather is pretty soft, I have to be more careful when I use this bag. If I overpack, it might ruin the shape and cause some creasing. This bag is definitely one of my favorite mini bags, and I love using it as a clutch when I'm wearing girly outfits or dresses. The next bag I'm gonna show you is a backpack. It's the Longchamp Le Pliage backpack in black. It's really versatile and really lightweight. I use it a lot when I was still in university, and I also use it as a travel bag. Longchamp has really classic styles, and I feel like the price is pretty reasonable for a good quality bag. And the nylon is actually pretty durable and lightweight. So if you're looking for a work bag or a backpack, I would highly recommend Longchamp. And I think they also have leather bags as well, but I personally really love their nylon bags. I've actually done a detailed review on this bag and I show you what's in my bag, so check out that video if you'd like to know the pros and cons of this bag and what fits in the bag. I've owned this bag for about 4 to 5 years and I use it a lot, and so far I don't see any major damages, maybe just a little bit of scratches and scuffs. But to be honest, when you see the bag in real life, you can't really see any damages. It has a zip closure and also a snap button closure, so it's really secure, and you can use it as a travel bag. As you can see, it can fit a lot. It can fit my iPhone 8 Plus, a scarf, and also a book, and of course my sunglasses and some makeup items. Even though it's not the most gorgeous bag that I own in my collection, it's definitely one of my most used bags because it's really practical and lightweight. This bag also comes in different colors, including red, blue, beige, pink, and a lot of beautiful pastel colors. It goes really well with casual outfits and also smart casual if you want to use it for work. So I would highly recommend this bag. So the last bag I'm gonna show you in this video is also a Longchamp bag. It's the Longchamp Le Pliage tote bag in this antique pink color. I've done a detailed review on this bag, so check out that video if you wanna know the pros and cons of this bag and how I style this bag. This is the perfect work bag for me because it's really classic, it's really understated, and it's in a neutral color, so it goes well with a lot of outfits. And the most important thing is it's really lightweight, so even when I'm carrying my 13-inch laptop, my water bottle, umbrella, and some other stuff, it's still pretty lightweight and it won't really hurt my shoulders. That's really important as a work bag. And if you're a university student, I would also recommend using this bag as a school bag because when comparing to other designer brands like the Louis Vuitton Never Full tote bag, the Longchamp tote bag is more affordable, but still it's really luxurious and classic. It can fit my 13-inch laptop no problem, and I also like putting a scarf or a cardigan in this bag because the aircon is pretty cold in Hong Kong. The shoulder straps are also very comfortable and they won't really dig into your shoulders. So this wraps up my luxury handbag collection for 2020. I'm planning to perhaps add one or two more bags to my collection in 2021, and I'll make another video dedicated to my Sunref bags. I'll show my entire Sunref collection including their bags and SLGs, so make sure you're subscribed and stay tuned. Thanks for watching as always. If you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!